This is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time we are continuing our playthrough of the Innsmouth conspiracy campaign with Sister Mary. Last time we were defeated in the first scenario, the Pit of Despair. We got a physical trauma for Sister Mary, which isn't optimal because she has a low health total to begin with. We still managed to continue to the next scenario, which is the Vanishing of Elina Harper. So let's look at Sister Mary's deck first. We only got 3 experience from the last scenario. I dropped 1 Ward of Protection to add Dynamite Blast level 3 into the deck. So Dynamite Blast level 3 is a new card that came in Nathaniel Cho's deck. It's a fast event which can be played during any fast trigger window. So it is really ideal if Sister Mary gets bogged down with enemies. She can just use the Dynamite Blast and maybe destroy those enemies, or if a location has a lot of enemies and she can't get past that, she can clear the way with the Dynamite Blast. Other than that, the deck remains the same. I won't go into the detail of the rest of the deck now, because there is a lot of story text to be read. I will skip to that now. We are playing the Vanishing of Elina Harper scenario, and let's start with the story text. Wednesday, August 17th, 1927, 5 weeks earlier. Wake up, dammit. Agent Dawson shakes you awake with his right hand. You are in the passenger seat of a pristine, state-of-the-art motor car, its polished body glowing with light from the moon as it rolls through the foggy Massachusetts countryside. We're almost there, Dawson informs you. Unfortunately, Innsmouth lacks a working railroad, which you would have preferred. There is a bus that runs from Boston to Newburyport and another that runs from Newburyport to Innsmouth, but Dawson had insisted on driving you there himself. Perhaps to provide you an escape route should things go sour, or to show off his expensive automobile, probably both. As you arrive in Innsmouth, the stale odor of day-old fish and decrepit, musty buildings washes over you. Many of the buildings along the western side of the town seem to be abandoned, though you occasionally spot figures in some of the windows. You imagine Agent Dawson's opulent car must make quite an impression in such a dirty and dingy town. You joke that perhaps he should have driven her here in a jalopy, to which he replies with a smirk, "That's never been my style." Eventually you reach a defunct railroad station that was given up years ago. A few train cars sit abandoned on the tracks, and the depot is boarded up and condemned. Dawson suddenly grimaces and points to another vehicle in the open lot. That's Agent Harper's Breezer. Let's park here and continue on foot. We can move through the town a little easier that way, he reasons. You check Agent Harper's vehicle before continuing, but it contains no clues as to her whereabouts. From there, you head eastwards beside the Manusex River, passing numerous deserted warehouses, sudden alleyways, and standoffish townsfolk. Harper got to be somewhere in this forsaken town. Residents don't look all too friendly. Wouldn't be surprised if she drew too much attention from a local mob or the like. Dawson begins to contemplate aloud. You ask how he knows his agent isn't simply keeping a low profile. Oh yes. Well, we have a code phrase for that. If she had sent me a letter saying she had some errands to run, that would have signaled that she would be out of touch for a short while. Without that signal, I have to assume the worst. To the northeast, several factory buildings loom over the rest of the town's saggy gambrel building roofs. Couplouts and widows' walks. None of the locals stop to greet you along your way, given the repulsive countenance that many of them bear. Their aversion to the usual small town pleasantries is a relief. Eventually, you reach the town square just south of the manuscripts. Though even these crumbling brick buildings that surround the supposed heart of the town inspired little confidence in ancient harbor's safety. An old bus idles nearby, its greasy-looking driver leaning against the door, eyeing you suspiciously. With little else to go on, you decide to split up, knowing that you can cover more ground that way. Canvas the locals and learn more about this town, Dawson says. Find out who the big shots are in this hellhole. One of them is bound to know where Harper was last seen, or who she was with. I'm going to see if I can find where she was hiding out and look for some sign of her. Meet up with me here at 1900 hours, understood? You nod in agreement and go your separate ways. The first person you check with is the bus driver, who probably has a decent understanding of the town. His coarse gray skin is first thing you notice, followed swiftly by unusual deep and shadowed creases in the flesh of his neck, almost as if he were prematurely aged. His bulging eyes are unsettling, and you're suddenly unsure whether you've seen him blink even once as you approach. You start to offer your hand as you introduce yourself, then, thinking better of it, just in case that the man has some kind of a disease you've never heard of. He introduces himself as Joe Sargent and gives you an useful, curiously rundown of some of the nearby buildings. So next there are a lot of text about these locations, and I won't read them because that would take so much time, so I just skip them. If you are playing this, I recommend you to read it if you're not familiar with, for example, the Innsmouth, the Shadows over Innsmouth novel, so you can get a bit more information about Innsmouth this way. So the story text continues. Finally, Mr. Sargent asks you what you're doing in Innsmouth. You dodge the question with one of your own, asking him if he has seen anybody around town matching Agent Harper's description. He pauses, then shakes his head. Never seen her, he mutters, refusing to meet your gaze. You spend the rest of the day learning the layout of the town and attempting in vain to make conversation with the locals. The more time you spend in this strange, squalid town, the more you wish you had never taken Agent Dawson up on his offer. There is something foul in the air here, something rotten and fetid that disturbs you to your core. Later that night, you meet up with Agent Dawson in the now deserted town square and share what you have learned. Take a look at this, he says, handing you a creased ink-stained letter addressed to him. Turns out Harper had a room at this disgusting old hotel. Still does technically, but it seems like she had been around for a few days. I broke in and found this among her things. Judging from the unmailed letter, it seems Agent Harper knew someone in town was tracking her movements. I'm being followed, the missive explains. Don't know how they know what they know. It's like the whole town is in on something. I have no contacts here from whom I trust. It's going to require more than one agent to sort this out, I fear. The letter is cut short. Well, she has more than one agent now, Dawson says bitterly once you are done reading. There's only one reason she wouldn't have sent this letter. Harper's in danger and somebody is in this balled up tongue knows where she is. Together, you begin to formulate a plan to find Agent Harper. First, narrow down her last known location. Second, find out who knew she was in town. Then, pay them a visit. Okay, and then we have the setup. So, I have set up the scenario. And we have this leads deck, which contains five locations and five enemy cards, which are shuffled together. Before that, we took two cards, one from the characters, the enemies, and one from the locations at random, and put it under this Finding Agent Harper card. So we know the culprit and the location Agent Harper is being held is underneath this card. So what we need to do is get these cards revealed and onto the table and investigate them to narrow down the suspects and the possible hideout. So let's read the agenda. So agenda 1A, decrepit decay. Furtiveness and secretiveness seemed universal in this hushed city of alienage and death, and I could not escape the sensation of being watched from ambush on every hand by sly, staring eyes that never shut. H.P. Lovecraft, the shadow over Innsmouth. Forced, if you defeat a suspect enemy other than the kidnapper, take control of each clue of that enemy. Record in your campaign log, name of enemy is out for blood. Then we have Act 1A, the search for Agent Harper. The next morning, you and Agent Dawson split up and search for his missing agent. Fast trigger ability. The investigators spend X clues per investigator as a group parlay. Reveal the top X cards of the leads deck to a maximum of 3 and draw one of them. Shuffle the rest back into the leads deck along with the top card of the encounter deck. Group limit once per round. Objective, you may advance at the end of any round. Hint, you will have to make an accusation when you advance. Advance when you believe you are have narrowed down Agent Harper's kidnapper and whereabouts. That is the setup done. We start at the Innsmouth Square. Just one reminder from the last scenario. Before we got defeated, we unfortunately hit Sister Mary's signature weakness, which changed the 10 blessed tokens from the back to cursed tokens. So we have 10 cursed tokens and one blessed token in the back at the start of the scenario. There are no rules in the pamphlet about you removing the curse and blessed tokens between scenarios, so I assume they stay in the back. And also during setup, we added two blessed tokens from Sister Mary's ability into the back. So we have quite a lot of curse tokens in the back. And I think we need to start getting rid of those as fast as possible. That is enough of the scenario and the deck we are playing, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so we'll draw our opening hand. So we get Sixth Sense, Guardian Angel, Sword Cane, another Sword Cane, and Second Wind. I think we will mulligan these two. So we get Hallowed Mirror and David Renfield. So a really good start right from the start with the cards. I think I need to just play down Sixth Sense and start investigating and hopefully get rid of those curse tokens as fast as possible. Okay, I think first action will be to play down Sixth Sense. Actually, let's first action play down David Renfield. And I will add one Doom on Renfield. I will exhaust Renfield. So we get one resource back. Second action, I will play Sixth Sense. And last action, I will start investigating. So I'll use the Sixth Sense to investigate, so 4 versus 4. And this is basically just to try to get rid of as many curse tokens at the start of the scenario. Oh yeah, and yeah, now I try to remember better to add the less tokens into the bag at the end of the round. Okay, so investigating 4 versus 4. 5 versus 4 because of David Renfield. So we get a skull. And skull is the current agenda number. So we actually get this clue. Well, our plan isn't working. I think our first... I will use this fast triggered ability to spend the clue. And we'll look at the top card of the leads deck. And it is Otte Gilman, proprietress of the hotel. So Otera is 3-5 health and 3 evade humanoid suspect elite. Revelation put Otera Gilman into play at the Gilman house with one clue on her. She is aloof. Action, spend 3 resources parlay, take control of one of the clues on Otera Gilman. Then if there are no clues on her, add her to the victory display. So we'll just put her here. So we know that Otera Gilman is not the culprit because she is not under this card. So we could just cross out Otera Gilman when we make the accusation. But yeah, that is our first turn. No enemies that have Hunter or anything, so we go to upkeep. We draw a card. We gain read the signs, and we gain one resource. And that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom to the agenda. Encounter card is Crypt Chill. Okay, so I think I will want to try and succeed. Before that, well, I'll take a risk here. So I'll add a Doom and exhaust David Renfield to gain 2 resources. And I'm testing 5 versus 4. Yeah, I think it's there are so many curse tokens that will just fail this and get rid of David. Okay, so -2. We still didn't get rid of any curse tokens. I assure you they are in the bag, but we're not hitting them. So we get rid of David Renfield, but at least we got the resources. So that is the Mythos Fest done. We'll play, I think I'll play the Guardian Angel. Oh yeah, we should have added one less token into the bag, but I won't redraw now. Then we'll play the Hallowed Mirror. And we get one Soothing Melody into hand, and we'll shuffle 2 of them into the deck. And last action. I think we don't need to actually go there, so I think I'll just go investigate other locations. So let's move to So I think I'll go to the Fish Street Bridge. Okay. So the Fish Street Bridge is two shard location with one clue. Double action gain for resources. Limit once per game. Actually, that could be really useful. But that is our turn. No enemies. We ready up. We draw a card when we gain one resource. And that is the turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card is furtive locals. Test intellect 3. If you succeed, either take one damage or put furtive locals into play next to the agenda deck. If you fail, do both. Investigators cannot parlay. Forced at the end of the round, discard one copy of furtive locals from play, max once per round. And again, I forgot to add one blessed token into the bag at the end of the round. So we are testing 2 versus 3. I'm not even trying to boost this. I'm just hoping to get rid of some of the curse tokens here. So first token is... it's a minus one. Well, we fail. So we put this here and we take one damage. But I'll take it on Guardian Angel. We add one blessed token into the bag from Guardian Angel. And that is that. So we can't do the parlays. But let's, as a first action, investigate. Actually, I'll do the double action and gain the four resources. I think that will be useful. Then I will use the sixth sense to investigate. So I'm investigating 4 versus 2. Okay, so we get a blessed token, so we are at 6 versus 2, and we get the minus 3, so we succeed. We get this clue, and I think I'll just spend the clue. We'll reveal the top card. So we got Innsmouth Jail. Revelation, put Innsmouth Jail into play. Forced, when you defeat an enemy at Innsmouth Jail, instead of discarding that enemy, shuffle it into the lead's deck. Okay, and I think it's here. Okay, yeah, so it's right there. So I think next turn we could go there and try to investigate. Because it is a victory point location. And now we know this is not the hideout. So at the end of the round, we discard one copy of this. We add one blessed token back into the bag. And no enemies. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get clairvoyance, and we gain one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. We are of at 3 of 6 doom. The encounter card is on Wings of Darkness. Test agility 4. If you fail, take 1 damage and 1 horror. Then in disengage from each night count enemy. And move to a central location. So this is the only central location, but that really doesn't matter. So if we fail, we fail. I'm just hoping to get those curse tokens out of the bag. So let's shuffle quite well. Let's see what we draw. And it's a blessed token, so we are succeeding at the moment. And it's a curse token, so we are not succeeding at the moment. And it's another blessed token, so we are succeeding at the moment. Okay, this is ridiculous. And it's a cultist, so it's a minus 2. If you fail, place one doom on the nearest enemy. So now we get one doom on this enemy. So I think we need to deal with her. And we fail these. All are removed. At least we got one curse target out. Then we move here. We also take one damage. I'll take it on Guardian Angel. And one horror. I'll take it on myself. And because we take one damage on Guardian Angel, we get a blessed token to the back. And that is that. Oh yes, let's return this into the back. So, let's see. I think first action. We'll move here. Second action. Let's investigate. Actually, first action, let's move here. I will, as a second action, spend 3 resources and parley. So I'll take control of one of the clues, and there are no clues, so she gets added to the victory display, so we get rid of the doom. Oh yeah, let's reveal this location. So it's Gilman's house. It's a 2-shroud location. Deal 2 damage or 2 horror or any combination thereof. Limit once per game. So I think... well... We could heal up here. I think that's not a bad idea. So first action we move, second action we parlay, last action I'll use the ability. So I'll heal 1 damage and 1 horror. And I'll mark that this ability is used. And that is the turn. No enemies. We ready up. We'll add 1 blessed token to the back at the end of the round. And that is that turn. Oh yeah, upkeep, we draw a card, we get another sword cane, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 6. Encounter card for this turn is... It's the Innsmouth Troublemaker. Spawn location with the most clues. Hunter, place one of your clues to your on your location parlay. Exhaust Innsmouth Troublemaker if it does not ready during the next upkeep phase. This ability may be triggered by an investigator at connecting location. So I think I'll spawn this Innsmouth Troublemaker to the jail, so we are not engaged and we can start running around, dodging in. And that is the Mythos phase. I think first action I'll just investigate here. Actually, let's I'll investigate here. I'll try to get rid of these curse tokens. We are investigating 4 versus 2. And we get a curse token. So we're at 2 versus 2. We get a blessed token, 4 versus 2. Elder sign. Okay, so +1 if you succeed, add 1 blessed token to the chaos pack. So this gets removed, we succeed. So we add this just back in. Okay, well, we only have 8 curse tokens in the bag, and at the moment 6 blessed tokens. So a lot of tokens. And we succeed, we get this clue. And fast trigger ability, I'll spend both of the clues. I'll look at the top 2 cards. So, the reason I'm looking at the top 2 cards is now I can save 1 turn and get 2 things crossed off that list. So we get choice little and nurture green. So put nurture screen into play. If there are no clues on nurture screen, look at the top card of the lead deck. If it does not have victory X, discard it. Okay, so that's actually good. And I think we just put choice little back into the lead deck. Let's see if we shuffle the deck. Yeah, shuffle the rest back into the deck. So we'll put the new church screen into play. It's here. And there are two clues, so I think we are heading there and possibly using Drawn to the Flame or some read the signs or something like that. Okay, so we'll shuffle this. So now we have Joyce Little crossed off, Othera Gilman crossed off, and the Jail and the New Church Green crossed off. So we are narrowing down the suspects and hideout possibilities. Okay, the leads deck is shuffled. Second action, we'll move here. I'll spend two resources to move freely here from Innsmouth Square's ability. So there's a fast trigger ability, spend two resources, move to a connecting Innsmouth location. So we can just leap there. And I think last action will take a risk, and we will try and play Read the Signs. Actually, I'll save the resources and I'll play the Drawn to the Flame. We hit a bad trajectory, that's just bad, but whatever. So we draw the top card of the encounter deck, and it is Hunting Shadow. You must either choose one, spend one clue, or take two damage. I have no clues to spend, so I'll take two damage. I'll take one on myself and one on Guardian Angel, which will add a Bless token to the back, and we'll get these two clues. And this is once per turn ability, so now we can't use that. And we have to use it next turn. But now, double action, if there are no clues on the new turn screen, look at the top card. Yeah, so next turn we could do that if we want to, but we'll see if we have the time. Enemy phase, the Innsmouth Troublemaker hunts here. Nothing else happens. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get Rite of Sanctification. Not sure if I want. Well, I could remove the Blessed tokens. So we could try to draw the Curse tokens out. We'll see. And we gain a resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom, so we are at 5 of 6 Doom. The encounter card is on Wings of Darkness. Unfortunately we don't have anything to cancel that with. I think we are facing the Innsmouth Troublemaker, but we'll see what we can do about that. I just test this, so we are testing 3 versus 4. So we hit a minus 2. So we place one Doom on the nearest enemy. Well, that was a really unfortunate pull. And we'll move to a central location. We'll take one damage and one horror. And this guy engages us. And that is the Mythos phase. So I think we are playing the Sword Cane as our first action. So after Sword Cane enters play, yeah, and we can play it without provoking attacks of opportunity. And now I'm not sure if I forgot to add a Bless token at the end of the round, but I did. I'm not backtracking. So after Sword Cane enters play, immediately trigger its action ability without paying its cost. So we don't have to exhaust the sword gain, actually, because we don't have to pay its cost. So the cost is the action and also the exhaust sword gain part, as I understand it. So I think I played it wrong in the last game. Oh yeah, you learn something new every day. So we are evading. We are evading 4 versus... I think I'm just trying to evade 4 versus 2. Let's see what happens. And it's a bless token, so 6 versus 2. And a minus 1. So we succeed. We get reward of the bless token. So this guy is evaded. And the doom on it doesn't matter that much because we are advancing. We are at the witching hour, so we advance either way next turn. Second action. We'll move into the jail and we'll try to investigate our last action. We are investigating 4 versus 4. Should I boost this some way? No, there are too many curse tokens in the back. So we'll just... Actually, let's not investigate. I think the more important is to heal at this point. So I'll play the Soothing Melody. I'll heal 2 damage and draw 1 card. And we hit the Crisis of Faith. Well, let's see what we can do. So there are 6 curse tokens. We'll just dump it all here. So there are 6 blessed tokens in the back. So for each blessed token in the chaos bag, you must either replace it with a curse token or take 1 horror. I think I'll I only can exchange 2, so I'll exchange 2 into curse tokens, and I'll have to take the rest as horror. Okay, so I won't remove them, so I get 4 horror. that's painful. So I'm up to 5 horror of 9. Okay, that weakness is just brutal. When you're playing solo and the tokens don't get removed that much. Think in multiplayer that's not that bad, but in solo this is just agony. So that was the pleasant card draw from the Soothing Melody. So we heard a song that made us question our faith. We got a crisis of faith. And that is the investigation phase, enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep, this guy readies, we draw a card, we get promise of power, and we gain 1 resource. So now actually the promise of power is a bit bad, because we can't add 1 curse token into the back, so we take 2 horror. Oh yeah, and we add 1 bless token into the back. And yeah, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so we add a doom and we advance. So, followed. The town of Innsmouth grows more and more hostile with each day that passes. The townsfolk have caught on to your presence. And perhaps even the reason for your visit. shuffle to set aside winged one and both hunting knight cards into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. If a decision to stick together is listed under memories recovered, I actually have to check. I think we do have that. Yeah, so we do have the decisions to stick together. After several days of investigation, you meet up with Agent Dawson to check in with him. He shows you a figurine of emerald stone depicting some sort of aquatic monstrosity, a piece of heart-shaped amber embedded in its center. After the days you have spent investigating and researching this foul place, the creature is oddly familiar to you. I'm glad I roped you in on this case, Dawson says. It's looking less and less like mob work with each passing hour. Let's stick together from here on out. Choose an investigator to take control of the set-aside Thomas Dawson story asset. For the remainder of this scenario, he does not take up an ally slot. Okay, so let's see. We add these to the deck and we'll get Thomas Dawson. So Thomas Dawson, soldier in a new war, is a 4-cost asset. You get +1 willpower and +1 fight. Pre-triggered ability: after an enemy attacks an investigator at your location, even if that attack was cancelled, exhaust Thomas Dawson, the investigator draws a card. I'll just put it here because it doesn't take up an ally slot. And I think we don't have any chest piece assets. Okay, so we shuffle these into the encounter deck. And then we still need to draw the encounter card for this turn. And it is On Wings of Darkness. Well, how am I not surprised? I think we're just testing it. And again, hoping to get rid of... We're failing, but I'm hoping to get rid of some of the curse tokens. So we get a tablet. If you fail, take one horror. So we fail, take one horror from that. I think I'll put it on Dawson. Then we'll take a horror and a damage. I'll put both of them on Dawson. And we'll move here. This guy engages us. Really hating this thing on Wings of Darkness and this guy being in the central location. Well, what can you do? Okay, so let's see. First action, we'll try to evade. We'll use the sword cane. Okay, let's use the sword cane. It exhaust now, so we are testing 4 versus... Actually, I have this other sword cane, so instead of that, I'll play the other sword cane. So I can immediately use that. And now I have multiple tries with the sword canes. This is one of the things I did miss on the first scenario, that I could have both in play, and that would have made it so much easier to get a win in that scenario. But well, it's neither here nor there. Okay, evading 5 versus 2, because we have Thomas Dawson in play. Okay, so we succeed because it's even. So this is evaded again. I think I'm just spending these. No, let's stick to our plan. We'll move here and I will investigate. I really don't have the... I can't use this promise of power. It's just too bad at this point of time. So investigating 5 versus 4. We are at 3 versus 4. 5 versus 4. And 3 versus 4. And if we fail. And we put one doom on the nearest enemy, which is that guy, which is a shame. That is our turn. We add a blessed token to the back before we forget. This guy readies. Draw a card. We get the Spectral Razor, so actually we can try to kill that guy next turn, maybe. We gain one resource. So, I think that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The counter card is a locked door. So the door here is locked. Oh damn it. We have a strength of 4, so we could try to break down the door. But it is highly unlikely. So I think now at the start of the investigation phase, we'll just use these clues. I think I have shuffled this, so I'll check the top two cards. So we're hoping to get other locations that or persons we have already seen. Okay, so we get Barnabas Mars and the house on the water street. I'll put the house on the water street into play. I think I forgot to add this here because we took the resources. Yeah, so the suspect is not Barnabas Mars or Joyce Little or Othera Gillam. So we'll just shuffle this back and we'll put this house on the water into play. And it's connected here. So I think we are just moving there this turn. So first action, move here. Second action, we'll move to the Innsmouth Harbor. It's a 3-star location with 2 clues forced. After you successfully investigate Innsmouth Harbor by 3 or more, look at the top card of the leads deck, then shuffle the leads deck. Okay. So we could also narrow it down with that. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. I think that is our whole turn. So, here is the forced ability. After you successfully investigate the house on the water street by 3 or more, either draw the top card of the encounter deck or shuffle that card into the leads deck. So I think we want to read the signs here to only investigate once. So we only have to resolve one encounter card. And actually, because we are playing read the signs, we are ignoring the force ability on the location, so we wouldn't even do that. Yeah, I think that's the plan. So that is the turn. We'll go to the enemy phase. This guy hunts here. We draw a card. We get fine clothes. Gain one resource. Oh yeah, we have fine clothes. So if we play it, we'll move that guy. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 3, doom of 7. Oh yeah, and I forgot to read this growing suspicion. Just how fully the pursuit was organized, and indeed, just what its purpose might be, I could form no idea. HP Lovecraft, the shadow over Innsmouth, and the force ability is the same. If you defeat a suspect enemy other than the kidnapper, take control of each clue on that enemy, record in your campaign log. Name of the enemy is out for blood. Okay, and the encounter card is Initiate of Dagon. It's a 2-fight one health and two evade humanoid hybrid cultist. Spawn any empty location. While Initiate of Dagon has no doom on it, it gets plus two fight and plus two evade. Forced at the end of the round, if Initiate of Dagon is ready and there is no doom on it, place one doom on it. Okay, so it works quite the same as regular cultist acolyte, but you only add doom on it if it doesn't have doom on it, so it only gets one doom. So let's see. I think we have to. I'll spawn it near myself so I can try to deal with it. So we spawn it here. And first action. We will play Read the Signs. We are investigating. We add our willpower to our intellect, so we are investigating 5-7 versus 1. I'm not committing anything. Well, I could commit this Rite of Sanctification, so 8-1. Now I'm just hoping I hit many curse tokens. So it's a 0. We get both of these clues, and we ignore the. You may ignore any effect or keyword on your location which would trigger during this investigation. So we ignore the force. So we don't do anything else. We just get the clues. Second action. Well, I'll just get this. Use these clues this turn and check more cards. So we have Sawbone Ally and Shoreward Slums. Okay. And we'll put. We could put the Shoreward Slums into play. So it's here. So, it's a 5-shroud location with one clue. Shoreward Slums gets minus 2 shroud for each doom on it. After you fail a skill test while investigating Shoreward Slums, place one doom on it. Okay. And we know Sawbone Alley is not the hiding spot. So let's see if we already know the culprit and the hideout. At the moment, we know it's not Innsmouth Jail, it's not Shoreward Slums, it's not Sawbone Alley, it's not House on the Waters Street, and it's not the New Church Green. So we are certain it's the Esoteric Order of Dagon. And let's see. So we know it's not the culprit, or the suspect is not Otera Gilman. It's not Joyce Lil, and it's not Barnabas Marsh. So it could be Zadok Allen, Robert Friendly, or Brian Burnham. So I'm not sure yet we are ready to see who it is. Okay, so I think we'll keep on finding out more clues. So I think this is a risky move, but I think I have to do it so this guy doesn't catch us, because this guy hits hard. That's not good. Or I think we'll do this. So second action, we'll move to Mars Refinery, and it's a one-shot location with one clue per investigator. Double action, draw 4 cards, limit once per game. This guy gauges us, and last action we'll use Sword Cane to evade. Yeah, that's all we can do. So evading 5 versus 2. It's a plus 1. So somehow we are missing all the curse tokens this game. Well, I'm not complaining, but I really would have wanted to get some of them out before the next scenario. So we evade this guy. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep. This guy gets one doom. This guy readies and engages us again. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah. One card and one resource. So we get the Dynamite Blast and one resource. Okay. Yeah, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. We are at 5 doom of 7. Encounter card is Obscuring Fog. Okay. Well, let's just evade this guy. First action evade. 5 versus 2. And it's a skull. The current agenda number is minus 2, so we succeed. And this guy is evaded. Second action. Let's investigate here. We are investigating 5 versus 3. Oh yeah, let's put the skull back into the bag before we draw. I think I forgot to add a token last turn. I'll just add one less token now. So we get a tablet which is minus 3. If you fail, take one horror. We were investigating 5 versus 3, so we fail. Yeah. Unfortunate, we'll take one horror. Last action, we'll just move over here. Oh no. We'll move over here. Okay. Enemy phase. Okay, this guy doesn't get any more doom. This guy doesn't do anything. We go to upkeep. It readies. We draw a card. We get another Spectral Razor and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay. We'll add a doom. We are at 6 of 7. Encounter card is Winged One Hunter. It's a 3 fight, 5 health X evade creature monster hunter. X is the shroud value of the Winged One's location. It's 4. Winged One takes 1 fewer damage from attacks except for range, firearm, or spell cards. A minimum of 1 damage. Okay. Well, it spawns on us. And that is the Mythos phase. Well, I think we are trying to evade. I think I will commit one of the Spectral Razors to the test. So I'm evading 6 versus 4. And it's a minus 4 if you fail, place one of your clues on the location. Well, we are trying to evade again. hand. 6 versus 4. Minus 4. Oh my god. This luck is just turning on me. I think we just have to evade. Yeah. Basic evade. 3 versus 4. Let's commit the fine clause. 4 versus 4. And we fail. And we place one doom on the nearest enemy. Well, that was a useless turn. This guy moves here. These guys hit us. I take one horror and a total of 3 damage. Well, we're nearly dead. Yeah. I think we are guessing who the culprit is at this point. So, I just have to... I know it's the Esoteric Order of Dagon. But it's either Sadok Allen, Robert Friendly, or Brian Burnham. So, I think I am guessing... Let's guess Sadok Allen. Why not? A good as guess as any. So, at the end of the round... let's go to the at the end of the round first. So, we draw a card. Ward of Radiance, and we gain one resource. We are at 7 horror. I think I'm... I play the Promise of Power and die from horror if I'm not able to die any other way. But let's see. So, scenario interlude, the accusation. Read this interlude only when you are instructed to do so. So, okay. We add one blessed token into the bag at the end of the round. And at the end of the round, we advance this. So, the accusation. The time has come for you to reveal your hand. You've retracted Agent Harper's steps as best as you can and learned a lot about Innsmouth and its citizenry. Perhaps with this information you can narrow down where Harper is now, but if you aren't swift and decisive, the kidnapper will surely discover you are onto them. You have only one chance to get this right, one chance to locate Harper and surprise her kidnapper. If you're wrong, it's back to square one, or worse. So, read the scenario interlude, the accusation in the campaign guide. The accusation. Using the knowledge you've gathered, you must make an accusation in an attempt to locate who has kidnapped Elina Harper and where she is hidden. In order to make this accusation, the players must choose one suspect and one hideout from among the options listed on the Finding Agent Harper reference card. Note, the suspect cannot be an enemy who is currently in play or in the victor display, nor can the hideout be a location that is currently in play. Use this information to narrow down your choices. Once the accusation has been made, do the following. Reveal the suspect enemy and the hideout location that are face down beneath Finding Agent Harper in your campaign. Under possible suspects, possible hideouts, circle the names of the correct suspect and hideout location. If neither card matches your accusation, the investigators are on the wrong track and must immediately resign. If only one of the two cards matches your accusation, the investigators are particularly correct and may proceed, but they have angered the citizens of Innsmouth during the careless investigation. Flip over the Finding Agent Harper reference card and spawn the enemy on its other side at the Innsmouth square. If both cards match your accusation, the investigators are correct and may proceed. So let's see. We are narrowing it down to the esoteric order of Dagon and Sadak Alan. So let's see what we get. So we get the right location, but the wrong suspect. So the suspect is Brian Burnham. So we have to flip this card. And we get the angry mob. It's 3 fight, 4 health, and 3 evade humanoid elite. Hunter massive retaliate. Angry mob gets plus 4 health per investigator. So it actually has 8 health. Angry mob cannot make attacks of opportunity. Okay, well, it spawns the Innsmouth Square. How nice is that? And in order to set up the final act and agenda, do the following. Advance the act directly to the set aside act 2A. So we have a set aside act 2A. Then advance the agenda directly to set aside agenda 3A. And as I understand this, we are removing all doom when an agenda advances. If I'm wrong, then I'm wrong, but this is how I understand this. And if you know better, then just let me know in the comments. Okay, and put the hideout location that was beneath finding Agent Harper into play. Add one clue, additional clue per investigator to it. So we put the esoteric order here, and this guy is there. And it has two clues on it. And spawn the suspect enemy that was beneath finding Agent Harper and Elina Harper's location. Ignore the revelation ability for the remainder of the scenario. This enemy is referred to as the kidnapper. Oh yeah, and this Elina Harper is spawned there also. Just mark it with this. Remove the leads deck from the game. Done. You are now ready to proceed with the final act and agenda. So let's read the final act and agenda. The rescue. All of your evidence leads here. You must rescue Agent Harper at all costs. The kidnapper loses aloof, gets plus one health per investigator, and cannot be parlayed. Objective. Either the kidnapper in the victory display, or there are no clues on Elina Harper's location, advance. There are two or more investigators in the game. Both conditions must be fulfilled instead. So, at least when you're playing solo, you only have to do one of those two. And frantic pursuit. My frantic running ceased before I had covered a block. For at my left, I began to hear something like the hue and cry of organized pursuit. There were footsteps and gutter sounds and a rattling motor whizzed south along Federal Street. It's below crept the shadow over Innsmouth. Forced. If you defeat a suspect enemy other than the kidnapper, take control of each clue on that enemy. Record in your campaign log. The name of the enemy is out for blood. Okay, well. Let's see here. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Ready these. Let's see. We add a doom here. Then count the card is. Initiate of Dagon. We'll just spawn it over here. And I think we are not doing well. This doesn't do attacks of opportunity, so we could try to evade. And if those fail, We can resign. We have no way of getting there this turn. So I think I'll do that. So first action is try to evade. I commit Ward of Radiance to the test. Yeah. It's a minus one, so we evade the mob. Second action, let's evade the winged one. Five versus four. Let's put this in the back. Actually, let's back up because that cultist token was not in the back, and I forgot to add one less token at the end of the last round. Okay, so let's redo the first evasion. So we are at 6 versus 2. And it's an auto fail. So I think I'm just resigning. Well, let's try to get one more curse tokens out of the bag. So I'll evade again. I'm evading the troublemaker. So we got one curse token and one blessed token, another curse token, another curse token. Okay, so some help for the next scenario, and one blessed token and a curse token. Okay. And a skull. So, we are evading 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 7, 5, 3, 1, we are at 0, so we fail, but at least all of these are removed. And last action, I will resign. So, at least we got some curse tokens out of the bag before the end of the scenario, but unfortunately we were not able to go rescue Elina Harper. So let's read out the resolution. If no resolution was reached, each investigator resigned or was defeated, the town of Innsmouth has proven more hostile and unwelcoming than you could have ever imagined. At every turn you are stalked by sordid brutes and disfigured silhouettes, figures that crawl on all fours and watch you from the shadows with bulging, unblinking eyes. Fear that you have drawn too much attention to your investigation. You retreat to your hotel room only to find it ransacked. Your luggage is ravaged, its contents strewn out. Much of your gear has been stolen. Scrawled on the wall in black paint is a warning: interlopers drown in the lake. Proceed to resolution 1. You are cleaning up the mess left behind by those who vandalized your hotel room when you hear shuffling outside your door. Fearing the worst, you press up against the wall and wait in perfect silence. There is no escape from your room other than the narrow window of dirty glass that you don't think you can fit through. Your heart thumps loudly in your chest as you wait for whatever is to come. A knock on the door, a break-in, anything. You certainly aren't expecting a small letter notebook to slip through the crack under your door, though that is exactly what happens. After a moment, you breathe a sigh of relief and step forward to examine the notebook. It's an old handwritten account describing the history of the strange town of Innsmouth as far back as the early 1800s, though the author goes unnamed. The record seems to focus primarily on Obed Mars, founding of a strange organization called the Asteric Order of Dagon. You don't remember any manuscripts of this sort on sale at the local bookstore, nor do you think the town has any libraries to speak of. Where was this notebook found, and who delivered it to you? Curiosity gets the better of you. You open the door to your hotel room, but the dim, dusty hallway lies bare before you. The identity of your benefactor eludes you. Still, you can't pass up a chance like this. For the remainder of the night, you study the record, jotting notes in the margin as you draw connections between Innsmouth's past and the events of the past week. One thing becomes clear. Whatever this esoteric order of Dagon is, its members must be the ones behind Agent Harper's kidnapping. And just as Agent Dawson suspected, their motives seem to have nothing to do with evading prohibition. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. Record this under unspent experience in your campaign log, but do not spend any of it yet. You will be instructed to spend this experience at a later time. In your campaign log record, the mission failed. Proceed to interlude to the CCG. We got 1 and 2 experience, so not a lot. Otera is victory 0, so it doesn't reward us anything. So we got 2 from the scenario. Let's go to the interlude 2. Interlude 2, the CCG. Light flashes in your mind. Shadows drown your thoughts as the memory fades. You are lying once again on the rocky beach of the coast, your skull pounding in agony. Agent Harper leans over you with worry etched in her brow. Hey, you finally wake. You sit up, your muscles aching. It looks like the tide rose several more inches while you were out. The cold water laps at your ankles and soaks into your shoes. What happened, she says. What did you see? Check campaign log. If the mission failed, proceed to CCG 2. So we failed the mission, so we read this one. You tell Harper you remember your mission to find her, but that after a week of searching you hadn't been able to do so. The last thing you remember was somebody slipping a notebook under your hotel room door with some information regarding the organization called the Esoteric Order of Dagon. Oh yeah, that was me. Sorry, I couldn't stick around and chat, but I had some other business to attend to, she explained. She tells you that after several days in captivity, she finally managed to get the upper hand against her captor and free herself, but she was injured in the process. As if to prove her story, she opens her trench coat, and you see dark blood stains seeping through her button-up shirt. Several bandages peek out beneath the fabric. Just barely missed my kidney. Lucky me, eh? You complain that you were wasting your time searching high and low for her, and she scoffs hardly. You learned more in 1 week than I did in 2. I knew that you were onto something, and I wanted to help out, but I was still being followed, so I dropped off the one solid bit of research I found and laid low for a while. It was you who did the rest, really. Sadly, you remember nothing of the rest. Skip to CCG 4. Don't worry, she says. I'll catch you up. There's a lot you still don't remember. Just then, a resounding crash of thunder echoes on the eastern horizon, and a powerful wave smashes against the jetties. The sky is a deep crimson red behind blackening storm clouds that swirl around the sun and the moon. The celestial bodies hang together in perfect alignment. That can't be good. Harper's lips turn rigid with concern. Okay, new plan. Let's get back to Innsmouth. I'll explain what I know along the way. With a fragment of your memories returned, past events have become clearer. Each investigator may now spend the experience recorded under unspent experience in your campaign. Proceed to scenario 3 in 2 deep. Okay, so at least we didn't get defeated. Well, we got 2 experience. I have to think about if I spent them or saved them, because it seems that in this campaign, experience is not that easily gained as in some other previous campaigns. So now there will be a long wait for the next scenario. So until then, I will be playing something else, but I will continue with Sister Mary throughout this blind run of the campaign. So thanks for watching, and until next time.